Hello guys, yes, you saw it right, Snapdragon 865 will be inside the Samsung Galaxy S11. We will have a great uplift in performance in every sector. First, we will talk about the network. Qualcomm is claiming that this chip will be capable of 7.5 gigabits downlink speed and 3 Gbps of uplink speed. That is totally insane. But how it's possible? It's possible just because of new networking modem called Snapdragon X55. As you all know that if the network module is inside the chip, the power consumption will be low, but they can't fit the module inside the chip. So for that insane speed gain, they decided to use it separately. In comparison, let me tell you that the Snapdragon 765 will have the network module inside it. It's not X55 but a new one from Qualcomm, but it can achieve only 3.5 gigabits of speed. So Qualcomm just compromises with power consumption for the speed, and they will cover it later with other optimizations in the Snapdragon 865. There is one big thing. This is the first chip that is Wi-Fi 6 certified. So you are going to see a great jump in Wi-Fi speeds too. So with these specifications, we can say that Samsung Galaxy S11, all the variants will be 5G enabled. Now let's talk about camera performance. Yes, Snapdragon 865 is capable of recording 8K video at smooth 30 frames per second. If Samsung enables Samsung Galaxy S11 to record at 8K, the Snapdragon 865 will do the job smoothly. If this happens, this will change the world perception towards the video qualities. With this chip, Samsung Galaxy will be able to record at 4K continuously and in HDR, and I am very excited to test that out. It will also be able to record 4K 120 frames per second. That is too smooth, and we can put out the images from that too. This chip is capable of 960 frames per second continuously and unlimitedly. So if you are a slow-mo lover, be ready for that chip. Also, you can capture 64 megapixel of images while recording 4K HDR videos. This all is just because of Snapdragon 865 image signal processing speed that will be 2 gigapixels per second. That is totally nuts, guys. Even we don't need that high megapixel rates, but this is insane. This new ISP will enable all mentioned features like continuous 960 frames per second recording and 8K video recording and processing that at the same time. Samsung Galaxy S11 could breathe new life into photos too. With over 1 billion shades of colors and massive 200 megapixel pictures. No, you don't seriously need that many pixels in a single photo, and you probably won't get all of them. We have rumors that Samsung Galaxy S11 will use 108 megapixel lens. That is also insane, but maybe not good for low light photography, as the more pixels are there, they become tiny, and this is a problem for the low light photography. But we are happy that Snapdragon 865 is enough for the 2020. So are you a gaming lover? The Samsung Galaxy S11 is likely to continue in the tradition of past Galaxy S phones. The Snapdragon 865 chipset just gave us a preview of what to expect. Qualcomm is claiming desktop gaming quality with new tools that Samsung can use with Adreno 650 GPU. Yes, they are using Adreno 650 GPU to uplift their gaming section. Desktop forward rendering bring desktop quality lightning and post-processing effects. It will boost the game colors and the saturation and give the most elite gaming experience. Yes, we will receive GPU updates from Google Play Store. You heard it right. You can go to Play Store and update the GPU driver. This will help the company to optimize the chip for the latest games and remove the bugs for them. In past, we only received these updates with the big system updates that were just like one time in the whole year, so it was a big problem for gamers. Let's talk about the screen. Samsung Galaxy S11 will be using a 120Hz panel, as per leaks are telling us. The Snapdragon 865 is capable of up to 144Hz of screen refresh rate. Like the 200 camera megapixel support, we don't expect all 865 using phones makers to do 144Hz of screen refresh rate, at least not in 2020, but we will likely to see a lot more 90Hz and 120Hz screens in this year. The fingerprint scanner area is going to get bigger than before, so you can touch anywhere on the big screen and unlock your phone. Also, it's going to be more secure with 3D Sonic Max technology. With this chip, you can register two fingers at the same time and make your phone more secure. But who will use two fingers at the same time for fingerprint scanning? Depends on you guys that will you use this crazy feature or not. So the performance is going to be very improved with Kiro 585 up to 2.84 GHz. And Adreno 650, they are saying that with that chip, 25% faster graphic rendering. Wow. This processor sports LPDDR5 RAM that is going to be very fast and compared to the Note 10 Plus that is using DDR4. So friends, this chip will be able to process billions of instructions per second. So AI is going to be very improved. And the one thing that I tell you, that Dolby Vision video capturing, that is totally insane. It will be so fast that it will capture every micro moment of your face, and that video processing will be very fast. If you don't know about the Dolby Vision, you can search it up on the internet, that what is the Dolby Vision. It is that the chip will be fast enough to capture all the moments and every pixel of your face. The Samsung Galaxy S11 is going to be a very futuristic mobile phone if they use all the features of Snapdragon 865 chip. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned, hit that subscribe button, and I will catch you in the next video.